Giant Tubi.
And I'm Hopeless Romance.
And we're bringing another fine fan fiction of Before the Madness, Chapter 2, Mr. Schmee's point of view. Sorry for the lateness of this, and the music belongs to Oliver Wallace, Hans Zimmer, and George Bruns. Here we go with Chapter 2 of Before the Madness.
"Hello, sir," I said.
"How do you do?" he asked. So what brings you to my table? He smiled. "Well, you're in luck. I am needed a new bosun servant, someone that is willing to attend my every needs."
I looked at him with concern. "Well, sir, I like that, but what's the catch? I would like to be treated as a human being, as part of the crew. Take part of funding also."
"Yeah, my word, you'll be treated fairly and be a number one officer of the Jolly Roger." "Sir, we have a deal."
"James Hook," the captain said as he extended his hand to me.
"This is me," I shook his hand.
"Well, Mr. Smee, the first order of business is to have me show you your daily chores. Me and then we must hire a crew." "Yes, captain."
So there I was, the first officer bosun, captain of James Hook, as the first showed me the ropes. I was to wind his clucks every morning, prepare a breakfast, give him a shave, have him dressed. We hired a crew and got along very handsomely at first, then we were off to an adventure.
"The first couple of days at sea were boring. I did the usual chores for the captain and made sure the crew did their jobs."
"Then we finally heard news that the Black Pearl was cursed or running wild, sinking anyone and anything that happened and have a cursed treasure of Cortez."
"Caribbean and go northward toward the North Atlantic, where pirating seemed to be easy because the British and the newly formed United States were battling it out. We decided to raid supply navy ships of the King's Navy. One raid was very interesting."
"Mr. Smee, Royal British cargo carrier ahead. Ordered to half and form astern, keep the flag down. We're close," Captain Hook said while he was still looking through his spyglass.
"Captain," I acknowledged.
"Helm, terminus astern, half and lower the flag." "I am Mr. Smee," he replied. He told him. He ordered the helmsman to steer the ship towards the helm.
We snuck up from behind. As soon as that happened, their flagman spotted and signaled us. We were silent.
Halt, this is the RMS Queensborough. Who are you? They didn't say a word, only we continued to come closer to them.
Mr. Smith, fire the main guns at my command, Captain Cook ordered. Sir, I replied with a fast salute and signaled
the cannons. Mr. Smee, range 32. Cannons ready at range 32, I repeated.
Ready? Ready, I echoed.
Aim. I applied the call. We blasted the side of the other ship, then we heard screaming and someone man yelling at us, "Who are you?" "Raise the flags and fire again," the captain ordered.
I nodded and repeated the order. We raised our flag and fired again at the ship. Now it was damaged and ready for plundering.
"Alright everyone, you know what to do. Take the ship," the captain called. "Hurrah!" the crew exclaimed as among the boarded ship began to plunder. I swung over the ship and helped fight the sailors. It was a fierce. I made my first kill that day and it was very successful. We got plenty of food and from that gold supply vessel of the British Navy.
From that day forward, we were on the road plundering ships of the Royal Navy. Then on one plundering mission, it was foggy. We were near the coast of Maryland, was it? I don't remember exactly. I think the British reclaimed a town there called Baltimore. Anyway, there was a ship that we were raiding, and the mysterious Chinese man asked for an audience with Captain Hood, saying he had a parley request.
"What makes you worthy of seeing the captain?" I asked.
"Let's just say I have something of interest for you and your captain."
"Alright, I'll spare you. Follow me." Then we walked to the captain's closed cabin where I knocked on the door.
"Come in, Captain," I said, nodding my head as we entered he was winding a grandfather clock.
Turned to me, "Mr. Smee, who is this man, and how did the crew finish the raid?"
"Sir, they're finishing upon now, and this man says there's something they would like to want."
"Oh, really?" "Yes, sir, I have a map to many treasures beyond your wildest dreams," the Chinese man said.
Hook put his hands behind his back. "Well then, you have my attention. By the way, what is your parley request?" "Only spam is, the man said with a grin.
"I don't usually make deals with people I plunder, but you have my attention. Tell me, where can I have this map and what's on it? First, we must travel to Singapore and steal it from a man named Sao Fang. I warn you, it's heavily guarded."
At first, the sound of that, I felt the need to speak.
"Sounds risky, Captain.
Mr. Smee, keep quiet," the captain said sharply.
"Aye, sir," I said, and the captain sent me a hard glare. "You must excuse my servant," he said, and faced the Chinese man once more.
"Apology accepted," the other replied. "Mr. Smee, cup of tea for our guest."
"Hi, Captain," I said as I moved to prepare the tea and crumpets for both of them. "Do go on," the captain continued as he moved to set at his chair behind his desk. motioning with the hand for the Chinese man to sit in chair opposite.
I'll have to guide you.
The conversation went well into the night, and the two men talked about going to the southern China Sea.
Next morning, we set sail for Singapore, though I wasn't too thrilled about it. We plundered along the way and finally made it to the Pacific Ocean, where we plundered ships on the Spanish California coastline. Then the long trek across the Pacific came. We decided to steal plenty from the Spanish if we were going to go that far west.
And that is the cliffhanger of Chapter 2 of Before the Madness. I'm Johnny Tubi.
And I'm Hopeless Romance.
We thank you and have a good night.